हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज़ अ गेट 2020 क्वेश्चन फॉर 1 मार्क एंड इट इज़ अ क्वेश्चन ऑन एसक्यूएल एंड हियर ऑब्जर्व अ क्वेश्चन कंसिडर रिलेशनल डेटा बेस कंटेनिंग द फॉलोइंग स्कीमास। हियर इट इज़ गिवन 3 की स्कीमास, कैटलॉग, सप्लायर्स एंड पार्ट्स, एंड अ क्वेरी इज गिवन एंड हियर यू ऑब्जर्व अ क्वेरी। इट इज़ वन क्वेरी इन द आउटर साइड एंड वन क्वेरी इन द इनर साइड। Because one query in the outer and one query in the inner, we call such queries are called nested queries. What is nested query? Nested query is a query within another query. A query within another query is called nested query. We have one query in the outer, one query in the inner. Always, it is going to execute the inner query first and it is independent of outer query. After executing the inner query, it is going to give some output. That output will be used by the outer query. And based on the output of inner, outer query is going to execute and gives you the final output. It means nested queries are evaluated from inner to outer, or we also called bottom to top evaluation. Okay. We understood what is nested query. Now coming to the question, because it is nested query, first, inner query is going to be executed. Just observe what is given in the inner query. Inner query contains one table catalog, and from the catalog table, it is first selecting those tuples satisfying the condition where p number equal to p4. Here in this table, p number p4 is there for this row and also for this row. For this row, the cost is 200. For this row, the cost is 250, and here both are for P4 rows only. And in inner query, it is also mentioned a condition called group by P number. Because both are for P number P4, this is forming one group of the two tuples, that is S2 P4 200 in one row and S3 P4 250 one row. These two forming one group, and for this group it is finding the average of cost. Now what the inner query is finding? Inner query is finding average of cost. The average of cost here 200 plus 250 by 2 means it is going to find 225 as the output of inner query. So means inner query is evaluated, given the output 225. Now it executes the outer query. In the outer query, we have supplier table, catalog table. Because two tables are mentioned in the outer query, first it performs Cartesian product between supplier and catalog. Here, when you see the catalog table, we have 9 rows in the catalog and we have 3 rows in the supplier. When you perform the Cartesian product of supplier and catalog, it is going to have 3 into 9 combinations of tuples, which is equals to 27 combinations. In the 27 combinations, it is going to select only those records satisfying the condition S dot number equal to C dot S number. Here S is for supplier, C is for catalog, and also it has one more condition, and cost is greater than the output of the inner query. Here the output of the inner query is 225, so that now the query appearing like this means select S number comma name from supplier comma catalog, where S number equals C S number and cost greater than 25. Means what it is going to find in the final output, S dot S number and S dot name in the final output. Means among the Cartesian product number of tuples, means which is the result of supplier catalog, supplier cross product catalog, 27 tuples, it is going to select only those tuples satisfying this condition. Now we'll see what are the tuples that are satisfying this condition, S number equal to CS number and cost greater than 225. Now we'll see with respect to these two tables. Here, when you see the matching rows of supplier and catalog, these are the rows of supplier S1. Means for supplier S1, we have three matching rows. And this is record of supplier 2. So means supplier 2 is matching with two rows. And supplier 3 is matching with four rows as a result of joint condition. That is a first condition. Here, the first condition is S number equal to CS number, means the tuple satisfying this condition are here 9 tuples. Among these 9 tuples, it is going to select only those tuples satisfying the condition cost greater than 225. Now, first tuple cost 150 greater than 225 wrong, 50 greater than 225 wrong, 100 greater than 225 wrong, 200 greater than 225 wrong, 250 greater than 225 correct. So means for this combination, it is satisfying the condition SS number and CS number is matching, S2 equal to S2, and also satisfying the condition cost greater than 225. For this matching row, it is going to display SS number and S name in the output. So here SS number is S2 and S name is Balaji Furniture in the output of final query. For that combination, that is SS2 and Balaji Furniture in the output. Now we'll check similarly other matchings. Here cost 250 greater than 225 true for this tuple, this combination, so that for this combination also S3 and Premium Furniture will be in the final output. Here S3, Premium Furniture in the output. And next tuple, this is 150 greater than 225 wrong, this is 300 greater than 225 true. Similarly, 250 greater than 225 true for these combinations. Again, these two are the combinations for S3 row and Premium Furniture. For these two tuples, again, it is going to display the SS number S3 and Premium Furniture. SS number is S3 and Premium Furniture in the output. Okay, so that as a result of this query, it is returning how many rows? Four rows in the output. So that the answer of this query is option C.